Welcome to another episode of Saint Vincent Untold Stories. On this episode, we feature the La Soufriere volcano in Saint Vincent, the e-passports, goods that have passed their date, and many more. Big ups to all of my subscribers. And if you are new to the channel, hit the like button, the subscribe button, and hit the bell icon if you wish to see many more videos like this one. Imagine purchasing a new passport last week, only to find out that come the following Monday, there are new passports. You guys working at immigration, you wanna tell me that you couldn't update the persons who took out a passport last week or the week before that a new passport was coming and they could hold on a little while? Question. Why our own Vincentian citizens are dealing with the country like we belong at the back of the world? Imagine. You are creating a product for the entire nation, but yet you are withholding information. Oh, come on. It is said that the new pages in the new passports will show some important sites in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. So it's like when you're going to a supermarket and they ask for the passport, they would watch it and they would say, yes, where is this? This is the Falls of Balen. Can I see it? Tell me something. Is it a marketing strategy? Because when you go into an airport to travel, who do you show your passport to? Isn't it the immigration officers? Do you go on the plane and show it off to your fellow travelers and say, yes, this is where I am from? Question. The persons who took out the passports last week, what must they do with them? The one with the less pages, should they bring them in and get a refund? I have free access to getting one of the new ones because I can't understand this. I am sure that more persons applied for a passport between last month and this month than any time before in St. Vincent and the Grenadines because of the volcanic eruption. So you wanna tell me you guys had this idea and you didn't update the public? You made them take the old one and now you are bringing the new one? I told you before, St. Vincent and the Grenadines is definitely not a real place. So apparently, what the Prime Minister pointed out about expired goods coming into the country, it is true. Because we got our hands on some of those goods and they were expired and they came through the customs. And you know, the funny thing about it, some of those goods came from persons who were refusing to give them away. So you see, not only Nemo is causing the problem, there are persons who receive private donations to give away, holding up the products in which they are passing the expiry date and these products came to give away. And some are so selfish that they don't even bother to check if the product is expired or not. All they know, they are holding them back. And by that time, their mind is clear to give them away. It is like they have already expired or they came expired and they didn't know. Personally, I am not going to blame the donors from overseas because it was an emergency and we know something could have slipped through because they had to hustle to run and grab items in order to send home for their Vincentian colleagues. So, I am pleading with the persons collecting the donations. Please check to see if the items have already expired and do not hold up these donations for yourselves and play selfish with them. If they came to give away, give them away. Allegations are that the Orange Zone persons who was ordered to return home to the Orange Zone are not moving. And we can basically see why they are not moving. Why are they going back to the homes that hasn't been fixed? We must be truthful. There are good people on the red side and also good people on the yellow side. But over the 20 years in governance, some people really did a lot of wrong, you know. Some people mistreated their fellow neighbors, their family members. For what? Just to prove that your side run things, no matter what you do in this lifetime. Please bear in mind that the tables can turn any moment now. Remember, first it was the yellow side, then the tables turned and the red side had their share, so it could turn again. So please be careful how you cheat people. I had a little experience from when the yellow side was in power. But when the tables turned and the red side came in, I remember, you know, they took away a lot of jobs. It have persons who used to drive ambulance and so on, and they sent them home for no reason. They do not reach retirement age, but they said, you know what? From you belong to that side, you have to go home. And if you are qualified and well-educated, you'll have to face some pressure. The great Jamaican singer Richie Spice said, the world is a cycle. Anything you do comes right back around in a circle. Most times, we command untold stories, asking the PM to do better. It is because we check for the big man. We want him to do the right thing. He is human, and oftentimes humans make a mistake. But when we see a cycle of mistakes keep repeating itself, we often wonder, is this willfully? Imagine someone has a watchman job, or a cleanup job at a school, and still is on the road gang, or becomes a road gang driver. So it's like there's no opportunities for no one else. We are not against persons having more than one job. But don't tell me you are trying to grab everything because you don't want your brother to eat. You don't want your sister to eat because they don't support your side. Allegations are that a date is already prepared for the persons from the red zone to go back home. Total madness. It have a saying, say, that education is not common sense. And right now, the big man is showing just that. For example, if I'm from OTR and my whole siding for my roof is torn off, what you want me to do? Send me back home, and when I go there, I have to hold up a bucket or a ten slow and catch the water until your MP decides to fix my house? No, sir. Go out, do the assessment, come back, reason with me, tell me what is going on, that you are going to fix my place, and after you have fixed it, then you send me back home. Now so it for go. Why, you know, I hold up the millions from the people them. The millions come for them. It do not come for you all in the offices. So my question is, if you move the people from out of the schools, that mean you have to set up temporary shelters in the red zones because some of these people has no homes to go back to. Big man, though you have an advisor. You remember when we was in school and we did tables, and if we got any tables wrong, the teacher would take a rule and do so, swai, 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 and hit you six of the best. And when you got those six lashes, you had to get back into line. You do not want to get any tables wrong again. So that advisor needs some training. You know, some of us Vincentians are really hard to go with. Imagine you as a parent, run left your teenage daughter, run left your mother and father, 80-something, 90-something, because you only cared about yourself. Imagine you are in a different shelter and your 14, 15 and 16 year old is in a totally different shelter than you. How are you feeling now? Don't you have a heart? One individual pointed out that there would be an increase in baby making because of this hard financial time of extreme poverty. We have to understand the reality of life. While you are in a shelter not working, there are men on the street offering things to your woman. Because what? We have people in the society who don't listen. That this is the young people time and we need opportunities. With all those millions, I hope that we would see a factory or an industry set up in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, something like a fish processing plant, an agriculture processing plant, or something of that sort. And when I say that, I am not talking about a little 50 employees. I'm talking about 2,000, 3,000 people employed. You know what? It is time for Vincentians to look into themselves. With that being said, I want to big up the entire population in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, the regional and the international countries who are supporting and praying for us. We thank you.